Welcome. This is Accounting with Ben and Tchaikovsky. Our topic today is property, plant, and equipment, and more specifically, units of production depreciation. And this educational funcast is copyright, well, accounting's always fun, is copyright 2008 to 2018 by Bennett Tchaikovsky. All rights are reserved. Okay. So let's go back here to our problem for our Sahar's mom class call. This is the same one we just completed with a straight line question. And here we want to go through and determine the depreciation using the units of production for the years ended 12/31/18 and 12/31/19. So if we look at units of production, this is a little bit different than straight line and double declining balance. Double declining balance and straight line are both functions of time. They're not functions of use. Units of production is a function of use. So what we're really trying to figure out is on a per unit basis, based on our production or how the equipment's being used, how are we coming up with our depreciation rate per unit? And what's very important is when I go through and I do this, I only want, again, I've got a salvage value consideration, but I'm going to come up with a rate per unit. I'm going to take that rate per unit and multiply it by the number of units produced during the year. What's also important to note is that if I produce no units, then I don't do any type of depreciation at all. So let's take a look at this one. My acquisition cost, and we saw this from our prior presentation, is right here. So our acquisition cost was $500,000. So right here, my acquisition cost less my salvage value, and my total number of estimated units to be produced is going to be 20,000 units. So when I look at this here, I'm going to be getting 300,000 and I'm going to be dividing this by 20,000 or here for a total of $15 per unit. So every time I produce a unit, I'm going to be taking $15 of depreciation. So it's asking us to determine the depreciation using units of production for the years ended December 31st, 2018 and December 31st, 2019. So for 2018, I produced 1,000 units times $15 per unit. And this is going to give me a total of $15,000. In 2019, I produced 5,000 units at 15 per unit for a total of $75,000. Now, if I asked you to go through and to prepare the journal entry to record the depreciation expense, what would you go through and do? Well, when we look at this question in particular here, the form of the journal entry, we'll do it for 2018, the form of the journal entry when I record the depreciation never changes. I'm always going to be debiting the depreciation expense. I'm always going to be crediting the accumulated depreciation. So here I've got 15,000 and 15,000. Now, this problem wouldn't be fun if we didn't make it more fun. So let's make it more fun. So units produced And we had 12/31/18, 12/31/19, 12/31/20, 12/31/21, 12/31/22. So here we produced 1,000 and we produced 5,000 here basically for the year ended December 31st, 2019. But what if we produced 10,000 in December 31st, 2020? And what if we produced 11,000 on December 31st, 2021? And what if we produced, say, 5,000 for the year ended December 31st, 2022? Where are these numbers coming from? I am completely making these numbers up, so have some fun. So my total units produced is going to be 32,000. Now, what's interesting about this is that what is the most amount of depreciation that I can take on this particular problem? And the answer is 20,000 units. If I produce more than 20,000 units, I have to stop taking depreciation. And let's see the reason why for this. So my amount of the depreciation expense, and we'll say over here, my total accumulated depreciation. My depreciation expense for the first year, we computed that to be 15,000 or 1,000 times $15 per unit. Here, I had 75,000 or 5,000 units times $15 per unit. My accumulated depreciation at the end of the first year was 15,000. By the end of the second year, the total amount of my accumulated depreciation is my prior accumulated depreciation balance plus what I took this year, or 90,000. What about December 31st, 2020? Well, here I'm going to be taking, this is going to be 10,000 times $15 per unit, or $150,000. So my total amount of accumulated depreciation is going to be what I took this year plus what I had in the prior period. Now, if I look at my balance sheet, which is going to be my equipment less my accumulated depreciation on the equipment, gives me equipment net. And if I look at this, it's 12/31/20. My equipment or my acquisition cost is going to be 500,000. My accumulated depreciation on this equipment is going to be negative 240,000. And so here, my equipment net is going to be 260,000. Now, as you're kind of sitting here and looking at this question, what we're remembering is from our last discussion about straight line depreciation, what we kind of saw was that, well, my salvage value was basically 200,000. So what's very important is that when I'm taking depreciation, I cannot exceed basically over here, I cannot go, this equipment net cannot fall below the salvage value. So if I decided to go through and basically here take all 11,000 units of the depreciation, this is how we went through and we did this part right here. And so if I take 11,000 times 15, and I basically would be getting 165,000. Let's see if that's right. Yay, I can still add. Okay. So if I take this full amount of depreciation for the year ended December 31st, 2021, I would end up with an accumulated depreciation balance of negative 405,000. So I have a problem. My problem is I'm right now, my equipment net balance is going to be here is at, wait a second, it's at 95,000. I can't fall below 200,000. And what really happened here? Well, my total number of units that I was estimating to be produced was 20,000. By the time I get here, which is going to be 1,000 plus 5,000 plus 10,000 plus 11,000, I'm at 27,000. However, my cap is, really my estimated units to be produced was at 20,000. So what do I need to do here? So we're gonna create another column. So we've got units produced and then units taken, depreciation on. And what we're gonna do here is we're gonna still keep this at 1,000. We've got 5,000, we took 10,000 here, but now when I'm coming over to this balance in particular, right, I can't go beyond 20,000. So what I need to do is I need to say, okay, I've got a total of 16,000. How many more can I take to get to 20? If I take 4,000 more, I am then going to be at 20,000 total units. So here, what I'm going to go through and do is say that I've got this 4,000. So instead of this being this calculation here, I'm going to use 4,000 times 15, or that is going to be 60,000. So my depreciation expense, right here, so what I'm going to do here is now by the fact that I'm only doing 4,000 units, I'm now not over depreciating the asset. So my total net book value as of December 31st, 2021, per this example, is now at 200,000. What's also important is in the future, I don't do anything here on December 31st, 2022. Once I have reached my threshold, I then stop taking depreciation on those units. So, units of production. Units of production is not based on time, it's based on how many units we are going through and producing. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna come up with a depreciation rate per unit. What we are then going to do after coming up with that, we're gonna go ahead and multiply by the number of units that are being produced. But how do I make this problem a little bit more challenging? Well, what I would be doing is I would be giving you a production schedule. And I would say, well, you know, there was 20,000 total that you're depreciating on. And by the way, you decided to make 32,000 units. So you're going to have to know that once you reach that threshold of 20,000 units, you have to stop depreciating or else you're going to go through and go below the salvage value. So with that being said, that will conclude this discussion on units of production. Thank you for joining me. And we will go ahead and continue with double declining balance on our next installment. Thank you.